Hello everyone, welcome to the Linux Command Line Ultimate Tutorial Series. In this first episode, you will learn how to navigate in your Linux system using the terminal. In particular, you will learn how to print the current working directory, how to change your directory, and how to list the content of your directory. Let's get started! To show you how the navigation works, I will be using both the terminal and the file manager. So when you open the terminal as well as the file manager, you are always located in your home user directory. So if you type pwd, which means print working directory, you will see that we are located in home, our username. You can see the same in the file manager. So if you click here, you can see the current working directory is home and my username. So it may be easier to see it here in the tree structure. So these are the all folders of the Linux system. And I'm located in the directory home with the username lu. And there is another folder with another username here. So let's list the content of this folder. If you type the command ls, which means to list the content, you will see the same folders in the terminal, which you can see here in the file manager. So let's navigate into some of these folders. To navigate into the folders, you need to type the command cd, which means change directory. And let's go into the directory pictures. Here again, you can type pwd. It will show you that you are located in the directory home, your username pictures. So again, we are navigated from this directory into the directory pictures. And we can change this directory here as well. So if we list the content of the directory pictures, you can see we have the folder wallpapers, which is here, and several images. So now let's assume you want to go back to your home directory. So you need to jump one level up. So what I mean, I need to go from the directory pictures into the directory lu. So I type sd and then I type two dots. And two dots means to jump one level up. And now I jump back to my home directory. So as you can see, I am back in lu directory. So if I type this command again, I will jump into my home directory. Because I jump one level up again, so I jump from here into here. So pwd, yeah, now we are located in our home. You can of course use the absolute path. For example, if we want to navigate back to our pictures directory, we can type cd slash home username and the word pictures. As you can see, we are back into our directory pictures. So which is this one. You can use this navigation by levels up into more complicated way. For example, if you type cd two dots, then you put slash two dots again, it will mean to jump two levels up. So I press enter, and as you can see, I jumped from pictures to lu, and then I jumped one level more to my home directory. And you can confirm it here. Yes, we are back in our home directory. So let's go to the very root of our system. So which will mean cd and the sign slash. So now we are at the root of our system. And the root of the system, it means the top directory of all of these directories. So all of these directories, they are mounted to slash. Well, you don't see it here, but this is how it works. So in a Linux system, if you want to go back to your user home directory, you can use this shortcut. You just type command sd without any sign. You just type it and you press enter. By default, it will always bring you back to your user home directory. For example, if you navigate to cd slash usr bin and we type cd again, we've been to this directory and now we are back in our home directory. So we can confirm it again. So we are in our home directory. You can also see in the terminal prompt this sign. This sign also means my home directory. For example, if I navigate to the pictures directory, let's say to the wallpapers, which is located in the pictures. So now I am located here. So in the tree structure, you can see that I was in my home, then I was in my user directory, and then I jump into pictures, and from pictures I jump into the directory wallpapers. But what if I want to navigate from here quickly, for example, to my documents? So there are many ways to do it. You can jump one level up, and then you can navigate to your documents. So you will need to type three commands. Or you can type cd without any sign, so you will jump back to your username, and then you can type cd to downloads. But there is a shorter way. You can type cd, and then you put this sign, which means to go back to your home directory. So this sign is equivalent to this command. Then you type the documents folder, and you see, we are in our documents folder. So just remember, if you type cd without any sign, you always jump into a user directory. If you type cd with this sign, it will be equal to empty cd. So you will always jump to your user directory. But if you type cd with this sign, then you can use the name of any directory which is located in your home directory. Finally, I would like to show you one more thing. For example, if you want to go to your previous working directory. Previously, we were in the directory wallpapers, and then we jumped to the directory documents. And you want to go back to the directory wallpapers. You just type command cd, and you push the dash sign, which means to jump to the previous working directory. As you can see, now we are back in our wallpapers directory. And we can go back to our home if we type cd without any sign. So let's clean this terminal and repeat the commands again. So pwd prints current working directory. ls lists the content of the current working directory. cd allows you to change your working directory. You can use cd and then you type the name of the directory where you want to navigate. We used pictures in this case. If you want to navigate back to your home directory from anywhere, you just type cd without any sign. If you want to go one level up, you type cd with two dots. And if you want to navigate back to your previous working directory, you type cd with a sign dash. Now you know how to navigate in your Linux system using the command line. In the next episode, you will learn how to do some operations with files and directories. See you in the next episode. Thank you for watching.